गुड मॉर्निंग माई सेल्फ मिस्टर दिव्येंदु मंडल असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ग्रेटर कोलकाता कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड मैनेजमेंट अंडर GIS ग्रुप। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट हुक्स लॉ। दिस इज द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ सॉलिड मैकेनिक्स। दिस इज माई लेक्चर नंबर 5 ऑफ मॉड्यूल 2 सेकेंड मॉड्यूल। इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन आक्स। Now let's start. Today I am going to discuss about Hooke's law and elastic moduli. Hooke's law states that when a material is loaded within the elastic limit, the stress is proportional to the strain produced by the stress. This means the ratio of the stress to the corresponding strain is a constant within the elastic limit. So Hooke's law, actually Hooke's law states within elastic limit it is applicable. This constant is known as modulus of elasticity or Young's modulus The ratio of tensile stress or compressive stress to the corresponding strain is a constant. This ratio is known as Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity, is denoted by capital E. Actually, E that is equal to stress by strain. Okay, either it is tensile stress by tensile strain or it is compressive stress by compressive strain. So, capital E is equal to sigma by small e or epsilon. Another one is the modulus of rigidity or shear modulus. The ratio of shear stress to the corresponding shear strain within the elastic limit is known as the modulus of rigidity or shear modulus. It is denoted by capital C or capital G or N, capital N. Shear stress by shear strain. So shear stress is represented by tau and shear strain is represented by phi. So let us define the factor of safety also. First one, factor of safety, it is defined as the ratio of ultimate tensile stress to the working or permissible stress. Mathematically, it is written as factor of safety ultimate stress by permissible stress. Actually, factor of safety, it is defined as the ratio of ultimate tensile stress to the working or permissible stress. Mathematically, it is written as ultimate stress by permissible stress. Constitutive relationship between stress and strain for one-dimensional stress system, the relationship between stress and strain for an unidirectional stress, that is normal stress in one direction only, is given by Hooke's law, which states that when material is loaded within elastic limit, the normal stress developed is proportional to the strain produced. This means that the ratio of the normal stress to the corresponding strain is constant within the elastic limit. This constant is represented by capital E and known as modulus of elasticity or Young's modulus of elasticity. One is the normal stress corresponding strain, that is equal to constant. So sigma by E, that is equal to capital E. E is equal to sigma by capital E. The above equation gives the stress and strain relation for the normal stress in one direction. For two-dimensional stress system, before knowing the relationship between stresses and strain for two-dimensional stress system, we shall have to define longitudinal strain, lateral strain, and Poisson ratio. Longitudinal strain, actually longitudinal strain, when the body is subjected to an axial tensile load. There is an increase in the length of the body, but at the same time there is a decrease in other dimensions of the body at right angles to the line of action of the applied load. Thus, the body is having axial deformation and also deformation at right angles to the line of action of the applied load, that is the lateral deformation. The ratio of axial deformation to the original length of the body is known as longitudinal strain. The longitudinal strain is also defined as a deformation of the body per unit length. Capital L is equal to length of the body, P is equal to tensile force acting on the body, delta L, increase in the length of the body in the direction of P. Longitudinal strain, that is equal to del L by L. Lateral strain, the strain at right angles to the direction of the applied load is known as lateral strain. Let a rectangular bar of length L and breadth B and depth D is subjected to an axial tensile load capital P as shown in figure. The length of the bar will increase while the breadth and depth will decrease. Delta L, that is the increase in length. Delta B, that is the decrease in breadth. Delta D, decrease in depth. Then longitudinal strain, that is equal to del L by L. Lateral strain, del V by B or del D by D. So if you follow the diagram, one is the B, another one is the D diameter, and after applying the compressive stress, okay, compression, B becomes B minus delta B and D becomes D minus delta D. So here L plus delta L, and here P plus P, P is the applied force, okay. Now Poisson ratio, if longitudinal strain is tensile, the lateral strain will be compressive. Very important. One is elongation, one is longitudinal elongation, another one will be compressive, okay. If longitudinal strain is compressive, then lateral strain will be tensile. Hence, every longitudinal strain in the direction of load is accompanied by lateral strain of the opposite kind in all directions perpendicular to the load. Poisson ratio, the ratio of lateral strain to the longitudinal strain is constant for a given material. When the material is stressed within the elastic limit, this ratio is called Poisson ratio, and it is generally denoted by mu. Hence, mathematically, Poisson ratio mu is equal to lateral strain by longitudinal strain. Lateral strain, that is equal to mu into longitudinal strain. As lateral strain is opposite in sign to longitudinal strain, hence algebraically lateral strain is written as lateral strain is equal to minus mu into longitudinal strain. Okay, so one is positive, another one is negative. Very important. Longitudinal strain is tensile, the lateral strain will be compressive, okay. Relationship between stress and strain. Relationship between stress and strain. Consider two-dimensional figure A, B, C, D subjected to two mutually perpendicular stresses sigma 1 and sigma 2. sigma 1 is equal to normal stress in x direction, sigma 2 is equal to normal stress in y direction. The stress sigma 1 will produce strain in the direction of x and also in the direction of y. The strain in the direction of x will be longitudinal strain and will be equal to sigma 1 by capital E, whereas the strain in the direction of y will be lateral strain and will be equal to minus mu into sigma 1 by E. So strain in the, now consider the strain produced by sigma 2. The stress sigma 2 will produce strain in the direction of y and also in the direction of x. The strain in the direction of y will be longitudinal strain and will be equal to sigma 2 by E, whereas the strain in the direction of x will be lateral strain and will be equal to minus mu into sigma 2 by capital E. E1 is equal to total strain in x direction, E2 is equal to total strain in y direction. Now, total strain in the direction of x due to stresses sigma 1 and sigma 2, sigma 1 by E minus mu into sigma 2 by E. Similarly, total strain in the direction of y due to stresses sigma 1 and sigma 2, sigma 2 by E minus mu into sigma 1 by E. Okay, so sigma 1 is equal to sigma E1 is equal to sigma 1 by E minus mu into sigma 2 by E. E2 is equal to sigma 2 by E. Okay. Minus mu into sigma 1 by E. Therefore, similarly, you follow the three-dimensional stress. Okay. Three-dimensional body subjected to this one. Okay. Here, first one, this one is the one important thing is the Poisson ratio. Lateral strain by longitudinal strain. Okay, lateral, so mu into lateral strain by longitudinal strain. If one increasing, another one obviously decreasing, that is the main point. Okay, and one relationship, and then one numerical problem. Find the minimum diameter of steel wire which is used to raise a load of 4000 newton if the stress in the rod is not exceed 95 mega newton per meter square. Here P is equal to 4000 newton, sigma is equal to 95 mega newton per meter square, 95 into 10 to the power 6 newton per meter square. Capital D is equal to diameter of wire in millimeter. Capital A is equal to pi by 4 into D square. Stress is equal to load by area. So that is equal to P by A. So 95 is equal to 4000 divided by pi by 4 into D square. 4000 into 4 divided by pi D square. Okay. Actually, P is given, sigma is equal to 95 mega newton per meter square, this one. So, D square is equal to 53.61. So, capital D is equal to 7.32 millimeter. Another one problem, find the Young's modulus of brass rod of diameter 25 millimeter and length is equal to 250 millimeter, which is subjected to tensile load of 50 kN when extension of the rod is equal to 0.3 mm. So, Young's modulus of brass rod. Diameter of the rod, capital D, is equal to 25 mm. एरिया ऑफ द रॉड कैपिटल ए इज इक्वल टू पाई बाय 4 इंटू 25 स्क्वायर, कैपिटल पी इज इक्वल टू टेंसाइल लोड कैपिटल पी इज इक्वल टू 50 किलो न्यूटन, सो 50 इंटू 1000 दैट इज इक्वल टू 50,000 न्यूटन। डीएल एक्सटेंशन ऑफ रॉड डीएल इज इक्वल टू 0.3 मिलीमीटर, लेंथ ऑफ द रॉड एल इज इक्वल टू 250 मिलीमीटर। स्ट्रेस इज गिवेन बाय द इक्वेशन सिग्मा इज इक्वल टू पी बाई ए 50,000 डिवाइडेड बाई 490.87 101.86 न्यूटन पर मिलीमीटर स्क्वायर। इज गिवेन बाय द इक्वेशन डी एल बाई एल, सो 0.3 डिवाइडेड बाई 250। यूजिंग द यंग्स मॉड्यूलस इज ऑब्टेन डी इज इक्वल टू स्ट्रेस बाई स्ट्रेन, सो स्ट्रेस इज इक्वल टू 101.86 न्यूटन पर मिलीमीटर स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाई 0.00122 दैट इज इक्वल टू 84 आफ्टर कैलकुलेशन दैट इज इक्वल टू न्यूटन पर मिलीमीटर स्क्वायर। ओके न्यूटन पर मिलीमीटर स्क्वायर, सो दैट इज इक्वल टू 84.883 इंटू 10^9 न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर, 84.883 गेगा न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर। ओके नाउ द टेंसाइल टेस्ट वॉज कंडक्टेड बाई ए माइल्ड स्टील, डायमीटर ऑफ द स्टील बार 3 सेंटीमीटर, गेज लेंथ ऑफ द बार 20 सेंटीमीटर, लोड एट इलास्टिक लिमिट 250 किलो न्यूटन, एक्सटेंशन एट ए लोड 150 किलो न्यूटन, मैक्सिमम लोड 380 किलो न्यूटन, टोटल एक्सटेंशन 60 मिलीमीटर, डायमीटर ऑफ द रॉड एट द फेलियर 2.25 सेंटीमीटर। सो द यंग्स मॉड्यूलस द स्ट्रेस एट इलास्टिक लिमिट द परसेंटेज, फर्स्ट वन इज द एरिया ऑफ द रॉड कैपिटल ए पाई बाय 4 इंटू डी स्क्वायर, पाई बाय 4 इंटू 3 स्क्वायर 7.0685 सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर, सो 7.0685 इंटू 10^-4 मीटर स्क्वायर। टू फाइंड यंग्स मॉड्यूलस फर्स्ट कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ स्ट्रेस एंड स्ट्रेन विद इन इलास्टिक लिमिट, द लोड एट इलास्टिक लिमिट इज गिवेन बट द एक्सटेंशन कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग टू द लोड एट इलास्टिक लिमिट इज नॉट गिवेन, बट द लोड ऑफ 150 किलो न्यूटन व्हिच इज विद इन इलास्टिक लिमिट एंड कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग एक्सटेंशन ऑफ 0.21 मिलीमीटर। हेंस दीज वैल्यूज आर यूज फॉर स्ट्रेसेस एंड स्ट्रेन विद इन द इलास्टिक लिमिट। एक्चुअली स्ट्रेस इज इक्वल टू लोड बाय एरिया, सो 150 इंटू 1000 डिवाइडेड बाई 7.0685 इंटू 10^-4। स्ट्रेन इज इक्वल टू इनक्रीज इन लेंथ डिवाइडेड बाई ओरिजिनल लेंथ। यंग्स मॉड्यूलस कैपिटल ई इज इक्वल टू स्ट्रेस बाय स्ट्रेन 21220.9 इंटू 10^4 डिवाइडेड बाई 0.00105, सो आफ्टर कैलकुलेटिंग यू गेट द रिजल्ट। देन द स्ट्रेस एट द इलास्टिक लिमिट इज गिवेन बाई स्ट्रेस इज इक्वल टू लोड एट इलास्टिक लिमिट 250 इंटू 1000 डिवाइडेड बाई 7.0685 इंटू 10^-4 35368 इंटू 10^4 न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर। द परसेंटेज ऑफ इलांगेशन इज ऑब्टेंड एज टोटल इंक्रीज इन लेंथ डिवाइडेड बाई ओरिजिनल लेंथ और गेज लेंथ इन टू 100, सो 60 मिलीमीटर डिवाइडेड बाई 20 इंटू 10 मिलीमीटर इन टू 100, सो दैट इज इक्वल टू 30%। द परसेंटेज डिक्रीज इन एरिया इज ऑब्टेंड परसेंटेज डिक्रीज ओरिजिनल एरिया माइनस एरिया एट द फेलियोर डिवाइडेड बाई ओरिजिनल एरिया. ओके दैट इज द फॉर्मूला इन टू 100%. सो आफ्टर कैलकुलेटिंग यू गेट फर्स्ट वन ओरिजिनल एरिया, देन एरिया एट द फेलियोर 43.75%. आफ्टर कैलकुलेशन यू गेट द रिजल्ट. ओके ओके ओके. थैंक यू. दिस इज द एंड ऑफ माई लेक्चर. इफ यू लाइक माई लेक्चर यू हैव टू सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड फील फ्री यू मे कॉन्टैक्ट एनी टाइम टू क्लियर योर डाउट. ओके थ्रू मेल और थ्रू व्हाट्सएप और थ्रू मोबाइल फोन. ओके थैंक यू. थैंक यू.